Here we go, fans. We're back on IPW Weekly Recap. Coming to the ring along with the lovely Fantasy, it's the man who calls himself the Cuban Assassin, Fidel Sierra. He's holding the belt from WWC. He's decided it's now an XWF belt, a la the NWO days. This guy, everywhere he goes, he causes mayhem and trouble. And another guy who causes mayhem and trouble everywhere he goes is my partner this week. Still missing in action is Ron Nene, but better, Uptown Frankie Capone, the current television champion.
You got that right, Aaron Royal Boy. This should be a barn burner. Donnybrook, Katie, bar the door. This should be a technical fest.
Donnybrook, isn't he a wrestler?
Speaking of Donnie, how's Rod Steele doing?
Rod Steele, he was here the last couple of weeks, but I understand he's preparing for a match we're going to see here in upcoming weeks. He said, let's give it off to my good friend Frankie Capone. I thought you guys didn't like each other after the way you went tooth and nail, but Rod moved on to other things. He doesn't care about the TV title. I think it's only because you have it, Frankie.
Those are some lovely, pleasing, flesh-colored tights, Axis.
Okay, well, Axis, no love lost between you and Axis or his partner Python. You and Python used to be partners. And there you see Lennox standing outside the ring in her short red leather attire. Okay, she doesn't exactly fit into the image going out there with Axis and Python, but it seems to work for this little trio here. Richie Rich in the ring with all his rats at ringside. Frankie Capone, tell me, Cuban Assassin, the veteran of the sport, but Axis, a big, powerful, young individual. I would say the nod has to go to Fidel, but you've wrestled both of these guys. You tell me your opinion.
I would definitely have to agree, Aaron Royal. I spent about a month and a half in Puerto Rico with Fidel Sierra, and I tell you what, he is one tough customer. Axis has no idea what to do with a man of this caliber and this type of experience. Axis can bench press all the weights he wants, but when it comes down to it, experience is taking the nod.
Well, I should have known the way you feel about Axis and Python, you'd agree with me, but I must say that is my opinion, and I'm not saying it just to kiss up to Frankie Capone.
You don't have to kiss up to Frankie Capone. The fact is, Python kissed up to me for a year and a half. I had to carry him, his stupid wife, and his mongoloid of a son. But the fact of the matter is, tonight, right here, Cuban Assassin is going to take it to Axis, just like Joey Maggs used to take it to Barry Horowitz back in circa 1986.
Wow, now I feel like Rod Nene is here with the old school references going on, a little bit more at home than I am when Rod Steele, who knows nothing about wrestling history, is here. There you see Axis, though. He got a nice shoulder tackle on Fidel Sierra. And I tell you, it's been said about Fidel before, but he is a top gun in this business.
Is that a girdle Python's wearing? I think that's a girdle.
No, that's not a girdle. That's Lennox wearing a red leather skirt. I told you that before.
Well, she looks a lot better than Coral, I tell you that.
Wow. Shoot fest going on here by Frankie Capone. Yes, that was out loud, as all your insults are. And that's why the fans here, even though they hate you, they kind of love you as well. Big boot by Axis. And if you calm down earlier, maybe get that three count. I don't know now. No, the veteran still has too much life left in him. And I'm really surprised I haven't seen Fantasy get involved in this matchup yet. Normally, if Fidel Sierra is going down with a shoulder stinger like he is right there, you'd see her all up on the apron in the ref's face. But maybe she's just a little bit intimidated by this Lennox outside the ring.
I tell you what. Python looks like a big fat cheetah walking back and forth. You know, he's walking back and forth, smiling to the fans, not paying attention to the match, not taking care of his partner, just like he used to do to me. The fact is, Axis will get tired of him sooner or later, just like I did.
If that's the case, maybe you'll start to like Axis a little bit more.
Never happened.
I didn't think so. There you see Fidel shoots him off the ropes, gives him a slap-elbow combination there, knocks the big man down. One, two, no, still too powerful and kicks right out. Okay, we have a lot of people outside this match, but none of them getting involved so far. And I would guess with the mindset of guys like Axis, Fidel Sierra, and all their cohorts, that'll change before this match is over.
Looks like Axis is turning about seven shades of purple. Right here, you're going to watch this STF right here. You're going to watch Axis blow up just like Michael Todd used to circa 1996 in WCW on worldwide tapings in Universal Studios. But the fact is, this is a wrestling move which Axis knows very little about. Hell, he could barely sell in the ring, let alone wrestle.
STF, a Japanese maneuver coming out there by Fidel Sierra. This guy's been all over the globe wrestling, and when you see him do stuff like this, it shows. It looks like he just turned it into a regular side headlock now, but still being very, very smart, wearing the big man down. You see referee Richie Rich down there to check. A, make sure it's not a choke, but it's got it across the top of his head. And you see if maybe the big man wants to tap out. Maybe he's had enough. I don't think that's going to happen from Axis. He may not have the experience of a Fidel Sierra, but he's got a lot of guts and a lot of heart, whether you like him or not, Frankie.
That's a really great babyface move. Real big psychology there, babyface going for the top rope. I wonder if you learned that from Adrian Street, Skull Crushers Wrestling School.
Adrian Street, Skull Crushers Wrestling School. You may be topping Ron Nene with the obscure references. Look, Fidel Sierra still looking a little bit injured, worse for wear there. And he takes the big man Axis right into the turnbuckle. You hear the fans, they're behind Axis, but they're not having a whole lot to cheer about right now as they've got a little bit quiet. They can't believe that Fidel Sierra, a person that they've been hating here at IPW for 4.5, close to 5 years now.
Look at this fantasy on the outside. I love this woman. She is doing exactly what you need to do to help her man out.
Now maybe she's not scared of Lennox after all. Maybe she was just trying to pick her spot, wait for the referee not to be looking, and that's exactly what she did. And there you see it in the background. Watch IPW Hardcore Wrestling. You fans are watching it here each and every week on UPN 44. Oh, a big, what is that? That is his forearm.
Axis is coming alive. Fists of Fury flopping back and forth like Strike Force circa 1989 against Demolition. He is the picture of perfection, that man Axis is.
They actually won the title. Demolition actually beat them for the titles in 1988 at WrestleMania 4.
Yes, they did. I remember Rick Martel had Smash in that Boston Crab, and Mr. Fuji came along and whacked Rick Martel across the back with a cane. 1, 2, 3, Demolition, World Wrestling Federation Tag Team
Champions. And the crowd goes nuts. But now we have to talk about the match. I'm getting like I am with Ron Nemi, where we don't talk about the wrestlers whatsoever, and sometimes they get a little bit angry about that.
Well, Axis is getting used to not being talked about. Just ask the Torch.
Wow. Shoot fest going on by Frankie Capone. Well, tell you what, I thought Ron Nemi was harsh when he's in here, but between you and Rod Steele, we're going to have even more controversy here in IPW, and everybody knows if there's anything we like, it's controversy. And look at that. She whips him by the leg, knocks the big man down. Here comes Lennox going after her.
Lexus?
Yes, she did.
Lennox going after Fantasy on the outside. Cat fight!
Cat fight!
Uh-oh, Fidel puts a stop to that right here. Comes Python. Cat
fight!
Cat fight! Never mind. Oh, and just bangs Axis's knee right across the ring apron there. This is what guys like Fidel Sierra hope for. They want to cause chaos and turmoil in the ring, get things out of the ordinary, get guys not knowing what's going on, and take a cheap shot, take back over the match. It's worked for him for 20-plus years in the business. There's no reason it shouldn't work for him tonight.
Look at Fidel Sierra laying those elbows into the
Fidel
side of
what?
That cranium. Sierra!
Look at you, Frankie Capone becoming bilingual on me all of a sudden. I wasn't even sure you could speak English all that well.
Wait a second. Look at that back rake. Hulk Hogan, Paul Orndorff, circa 1984.
5, 6. You're getting the angles right. You're getting the ears a little bit off. With all the shots you've taken to the head, I can't say that I blame you. You come out here with those tight hats across your head. It's got to take an effect, Frankie Capone. For crying out loud, please save yourself from those hats.
Beautiful Ultimate Warrior shoulder block by the man they call Axis.
He's going to whip Fidel Sierra across the ring there. Coming in for a power. Oh, big knee right across the choppers of Fidel Sierra.
Suicide.
Well, I don't know. It looked like a big something or other across the choppers. That's all I know. Fidel Sierra almost out on his feet and then gets raked across the eyes by Axis. He says, enough cheap shots by you. I'm going to take some of my own. And who is Richie Rich Kid? He can count to 100. He's not going to disqualify anybody.
Look at this. Takes the flag from Fantasy. Get by!
Oh, and okay, when Lennox is in there, you can barely call it the cat fight. She's stronger than half the guys on our roster. But Fantasy's showing that she's a veteran as well. She's getting the best of Lennox right now. I don't think anybody expected that. Now Lennox on top. Now Fantasy, oh, just watch.
Fantasy, grab her hand. Oh, she has no hand. Grab something.
Now the guys, let them fight.
Let him go! Cat fight!
I don't even know what to say here. Normally we're talking, but normally we don't have this kind of stuff going on, Frankie Capone.
I'm trying to look up Lennox's skirt right now.
That's not too hard, considering the nice work by our cameraman and our technical director here in IPW. We get all the great stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Noah Richie Rich
Lennox trying to
has disqualified both competitors. This match has been declared a double disqualification.
That is totally unnecessary and uncalled for.
This is disgusting.
Who would ever affiliate sex with wrestling? I don't understand it. Fans, we'll be back.